Hello YouTube, West Texas Prepper. Want to bring you a follow-up video to the one I posted about a week ago about obtaining water in an SHTF grid down emergency type situation. And I was talking to you about having portable pumps. And I showed you, this is the pump. Let me do that. Pump setup. I hope that'll show up. I don't think that will. A pump setup that I was using to drain a pool. And I didn't show you the buckets, but you can see in these buckets what I've gone in and done is taken a half inch drill bit and have drilled a bunch of holes in it. Now what I use this for is to pre-strain. These are not debris type pumps. And when I have to go in and drain pools sometimes in the spring, you know, they have a lot of leaves and debris and stuff in it. And what this does, it pre-filters all that debris out, the big stuff, and allows me to run the pumps longer without having to clean them out. And so what this does just acts as a big sieve and allows the water in but keeps the big stuff out. These pumps that I have, I've got them, this one's plumbed for 1.5 inches, will handle some pretty good sized debris, probably 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch, anything that gets in there. It has an open impeller design in the bottom, so it'll handle anything that it can get in the pump. And the pump actually has some, I'll show you down here on the bottom. Down here on the bottom, the pump has inlets here that helps keep out debris, and then it's just an open impeller in here. I need to clean these out, and then it just forces it up through the pipe. But this will handle some fairly large debris. They're not debris pumps per se, but I've had some things pump through them that are pretty good. Now these are float activated. These are actually sump pumps to go in basements to help with flooding. And so what I have to do when I'm just draining and I'm going to be there, I keep the floats taped up and out of the way so they'll run continuously. If I'm not going to be around, I have another pump that I use that those are loose and I let it float. The other day when I was draining, I had all three going. So you probably saw it. It was next to the pair that I had in there. But I was talking about using these to collect water in a grid down situation and how useful they are. Anthony over at Bibles and Barbells, and I'll put a link to his channel, and so you can see down the bottom, I've got holes down in the bottom too, and that just allows water to filter in through that. But we were talking about water collection, and he's fortunate enough where he lives to have a lake accessible, and he just posted a video this week on going down and using buckets and pre-straining and collecting water. And have been talking back and forth through PM about using a pump system, and I told him one of the things that I do is that I actually have a dedicated pump for just such a case. Since I am in the pool business, I basically in a sense have access to a lot of swimming pools here in town where I live, and in a grid down situation, those would be wonderful areas to get water, because if you can keep those things up and running and they're maintained properly, you can go a week and a half before the water starts getting bad. And then even if it does get bad, you can still treat and do what you need to use that water for either potable situations or non-potable. If you're needing to, you know, hygiene and things like that, you can use that water. It's still going to be good enough to do. But what I do is I have a pump that is dedicated, and I just keep it in a bucket. Let's see if we can hang on just a second. I'll get the lid off for you. All right, I'm back. That lid was on there a little tight. It's under a little pressure. But what I do is I have a dedicated hose. Now, this is an RV hose that I keep in here with it. So this is, in a sense, a food-grade hose. You can hook this. I bought this at an RV store years ago. You can use this hose to hook into an RV. And since I have the pop-up, this is actually going to be dedicated to the pop-up when we go camping. That way we can get water if we're near a stream or something like that. We can go in and get water. And then this is the pump that I have. And it's never been used. It is strictly dedicated for water gathering in those type of situations. And I've probably had this kit together, I don't know, 10 years or so, maybe 15. I forgot how long. I'd have to go and look at this, but real simple fitting, come out, hose bib attachment where I can hook the garden hose off. You can turn it off, has a cord, that I can run off an extension cord plugged into an inverter off my automobile. Either one we drive or just anything, you know, and it's a pretty cool inverter. You can hook it directly to the battery, or you can plug it into a cigarette lighter and it'll work. But this is my dedicated kit for obtaining water. And like I said, it's probably going to travel in the camper now when we go to give us another way to get water, but always have a way to obtain water in those type of situations. Now, as far as buckets go, one of the things somebody posted about not using a bucket that's not food grade. In a grid down SHT situation, that's not really going to be a concern of mine. Water is not going to be stored in these buckets really any longer than it needs to be as far as processing, gathering, and then using the water. It's not going to sit in here for years and have those, BPAs or PBAs leach out into the water. So that's not really a concern for mine. Typically in a grid down SHT situation, you're not going to be storing water for long periods of time anyway. And then in that case, that's going to be the furthest thing from my mind is having to worry about that stuff. But just simple, hook the water hose onto here, and then I can fill up containers. One of the things that Anthony was dealing with was a lot of the debris. And he had a pretty cool idea that he was using a grease screen, it looked like, and then a cloth over the top of that to pre-filter. And that was a great idea. It was keeping a lot of those big chunks and stuff out. You can always have a dedicated bucket like this. That would help keep a lot of the big debris out. But what I've seen from using this type of pump in a pool, even with a lot of debris in it, is that if you run it for 2 or 3 minutes, what happens is down here around the base of the pump actually is a clean zone. If you don't have large debris floating in to your pump, then this actually winds up being about 1 inch to 2 inch clean zone around the base where the silt just sort of stops and then the pump runs and does what it needs to do. So that was encouraging just over the years of watching that knowing if I can run this pump for a couple of minutes, I'm going to get some fairly clean water that doesn't have a lot of debris in it. Would I still pre-screen before I put it in a container? Yes, I'd run it through some type of coffee filter, cheesecloth, bandana, any type of cloth that's going to get out a lot of those larger products that could still make it through the pump. And I would still pre-treat that way. And then after that, you can always boil, filter, and however bleach, chemically treat it, however you're going to treat your water for what your uses are from there. But he and I have been talking, and in his situation, I was even talking about maybe a 12-volt pump. Now, this is 110, so it would have to run off an inverter. But going with a 12-volt pump, they make them, and that way you can run those off of a smaller car battery. And you could obtain water that way. This is fairly stealthy. These pumps don't make a lot of noise, even just sitting out here on the deck. They don't make a lot of noise. They're fairly quiet. And if you're running it off an inverter, you might or might not have to start your automobile, but even then an idling car does not make that much noise. But this is just the kit that I have. I wanted to show you that. You know, I can always use this bucket to gather water in. This is a chlorine bucket, so I'm not too worried about stuff growing in here with any residual chlorine. I do rinse them out and keep them clean, but with a little bit of bleach water, even after I clean them out. So I'm pretty safe with these buckets. So I'm not too worried about that. Those of you that are concerned about, you know, chemicals leaching into your water is not gonna sit in here that long before you do something with it. But I just wanted to bring you that quick video on my kit that I have together for gathering water in those type of situations. If you have any thoughts, ideas, maybe something you do different, please post those in the comments down below. I appreciate you watching. Go over to Anthony's channel, Bibles and Barbells. He's got some great information too. I love watching videos from other parts of the country. And the reason why is because out here in West Texas, things are different. We have playa lakes, but we don't have the readily available water. In some places they can dry up depending on the situations and be dry. So I like watching those videos from other parts of the country to see other thoughts and ideas that other people have and then adapting them for my use. And so that's why I've enjoyed talking to Anthony over there, is we're bouncing some ideas back and forth, and he's making me think about some things and rethink some things. and, you know, just giving each other some ideas. And that's what we're here for. We're here to help each other out. I don't claim to know everything. I always like finding out new information. And that's just my two cents worth. Post your comments. Please like and subscribe. I appreciate you guys coming by and checking out my channel. And anything else you need, just post a comment or send me a PM. We'll get you taken care of. This is West Texas Prepper. Do what you can with what you have, where you're at.